These are challenging times for Hawaii. We're mourning the loss of Senator Daniel Inouye, a leader whose lifetime of selfless service to our country has been noted and will be noted forever in our hearts. At the same time, this is an opportunity to build on the remarkable foundation that Senator Inouye laid. It's an opportunity to shape a future for the state of Hawaii. The state central committee, many of whom are able to be with us today, I want to say parenthetically how proud I am. What a great moment this is for democracy in our state and in our union. The real true grassroots representation of the Democratic Party and its values are represented by the folks that are here and represented of all those who couldn't be here now and are here with us in our hearts as a result of their deliberations this morning. The State Central Committee of the Democratic Party is engaged in a thoughtful and deliberative process in forwarding names for consideration of the new senator, a new leader who will continue moving Hawaii forward as well. The charge of the Central Committee was to take all points of view into account from Senator Inouye and from the rank and file of the Democratic Party grassroots. No one and nothing was preordained. The Central Committee gave it its very best thoughtful analysis and cast their votes. I have informed the leadership of the United States Senate, spoken personally with Senator Reid, the Majority Leader of the United States Senate, that I've appointed Brian Schatz as the next United States Senator from Hawaii. I ask myself these questions. How best do we ensure that Hawaii remains strong in the immediate term with the most capable and well-rounded congressional delegation, Senate and House, representing us in Washington today? And I asked, how best could we ensure that Hawaii remains strong in the long run, rebuilding the seniority of our congressional delegation in Washington? I made this decision with the full confidence that Brian's appointment is in the best interest of the party, the state of Hawaii, and the nation. I mentioned that I spoke to Senator Reid, and I spoke with Esther Kia'aina and with Colleen Hanabusa, both of whom expressed their support for Brian, expressed their gratitude to the Central Committee for their consideration, and both of whom said without hesitation or reservation that they are ready to work with Brian, work with the Democratic Party, work on behalf of the state and the nation, and that we are united here in Hawaii. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Senator Brian Schatz.
Aloha.
Aloha.
I'm humbled and honored by this opportunity and obligation to serve the people of Hawaii and the people of America. No one can fill Senator Daniel K. Inouye's shoes, but together, all of us, we can try to walk in his footsteps. That means always thinking about what's best for Hawaii, working together, and representing our values and priorities in the nation's capital. And for me in this position, it means the first step on a very long road. The first thing I will do is reach out to Senator-elect Hirono, Congresswoman Hanabusa, and Congresswoman-elect Gabbard, and establish our game plan for the coming Congress. Next, I will be in conversations with Leader Reid's office and other members of the Senate leadership to discuss pending urgent legislation. After that, I will reach out to the White House to continue our discussion about Hawaii's priorities. A critically important part of this process is to effect a smooth transition. I know Senator Inouye's staff very well. They are outstanding public servants, and I am confident that they are ready to help in any way. Tonight, I will leave on a flight to Washington, D.C., I'm not sure when, and will be prepared to be sworn in sometime in the afternoon and begin the work of the Senate on behalf of Hawaii's people. I will bring my wife and two children and both of my parents. Over the next year, one of Hawaii's critical priorities is to identify the various federal funding streams that have been coming to Hawaii and stabilize them to the extent possible. I will be in touch with the leadership of Pacific Command, the University of Hawaii, and of course, Governor Abercrombie's administration to remain competitive in terms of federal funds. I have experience with this since one of my areas of responsibility as Lieutenant Governor was to maximize federal resources coming to Hawaii. In terms of public policy priorities, Native Hawaiian recognition remains at the top of the list. And for me personally, I believe global climate change is real and it is the most urgent challenge of our generation. I thank Governor Abercrombie for the opportunity to serve in this capacity. I'm honored and I'm humbled by his trust. To the people of Hawaii, I can assure you this. I will give every fiber of my being to doing a good job for the state of Hawaii. We have a long and perhaps difficult road ahead of us, but we can succeed if we work together. I understand the magnitude of this obligation and this honor, and I won't let you down. Mahalo.